Hi, I'm Khandie, and if you have ever been on social media anywhere, you will have seen somebody write about, I can't get clients through the door, I don't know how to get clients, I'm really struggling, I'm going to give it all up. And this is common in most photography businesses, in most forums that I've seen, people have had this. I myself have had this, but this is some hard-hitting questions, how-tos, perhaps whatever mistakes maybe that you are making. And so many people bypass all this because they just think clients are going to roll through the door because they put some pretty pictures out. So this is where it's going. It's going to be hard. It's going to be quite cutting. And the last one I'm giving no apologies for, because sometimes you just got to hear it. You sit on social media and you have no idea how to use it. Now, don't get me wrong, there's so much about social media that's ever changing, so you'll never know 100%. But if you are not regularly just checking in what's changing, even if you just follow a marketing thing, like a marketing TikTok or a podcast, make the time, because that's part of your education. That's part of your marketing that should be in your business plan. I saw people who don't even know about using hashtags on Facebook posts. Like, oh, I didn't know you could do that. It's been around. It's been around for ages. Instagram and Facebook came together and they merged all sorts of stuff. Or even the fact that people are not even using the send message on Facebook, or the scrolling top where on the cover where you can have multiple images, all of that, or going on Instagram going, I don't want to do reels. Well, if you're not doing reels and Instagram have told you video content is king and where they're going, that's why your Instagram isn't taking off. It might be working now, but that is where they're aiming. And if you're not prepared to do that, why would clients be prepared to come to you? Now, you don't need to jump through loads of hoops. You can repurpose content, and there are numerous places where you can repurpose content. Showing behind the scenes, showing you doing how to wrap a bit, whatever it is, those could be short reels, 10 questions. If you are too scared to put yourself in front of the camera, why would your clients want to go in front of your camera? Like, if you can't make yourself comfortable in front of the camera, what does that convey to your clients? They're not going to be comfortable because you don't know how to make them comfortable. You don't feel comfortable, so you haven't overcome it. So how are they going to overcome it? You have to start being business-minded and pushing it. And I know that's hard because so many people have anxiety about being over the camera. And I know that your customers are expected to stand in front of the camera with you. So you need to show that you can do it also. One of the ones it always boils down to is money. People do not cost themselves properly. They do not understand the cost of doing business. Yes, I've done a whole video on it. It's somewhere up here. I'll put a link on it if I remember. But people don't remember about costings. They go, oh yeah, I made the X amount of money. Yay. And they forget, actually, you need to be making sure that in order to get that money, it looks like the client's getting value for that money, okay? They might get a really pretty frame, but was it awkward to work with you? Do you have to send 99 emails to get them to do so? Is it not automated? Is there not a system, like a client management software that puts all the stuff together in a client portal? I know I do use PixieSet, and I have all the links below, and they are referral codes, but think about your systems. If you're trying to chase those higher end clients, everything should say higher end. It's the same when you come to your studio. If you're lucky enough to have a studio somewhere else from your home, it has to look high end. From the moment they step into your studio, everything about you must say what you're trying to convey. And if you go, I haven't got time, guess what? You should have factored this into your business time. Like, when I was shooting so much that I knew I was going to slip on getting the studio clean between sessions, I knew I had to get a cleaner in. I knew I needed someone to be cleaning while I was doing the editing and the stuff behind the scenes. That was a hit I took. I had that planned in my business plan. I have a great cleaner, and it's what I do. And you need to be start to recognize this. Sometimes paying for something to be done actually saves you time. Because remember, in business, time is money. So it might be that you're paying someone to do something, but it saves you time. It saves you money, and technically gives some of your life outside of work back. And if you go, I can't afford it, you need to look at your prices. Because if you start doing everything in this line, maybe you'll start getting those clients in, because they will see that you are a little bit more put together, a little bit more bougie, a little bit more worth the money. Are you just self-serving? Essentially, are you telling everybody how great you are without telling them how great they are? Do you just share your own content? Do you not find playlists that you might like? I love this music. I have this on at the background of the studio when I'm working. What music would you add to our playlist? What's your funky tune? What's your, like, all this, get them to talk to you. One, builds connection. But if all you're doing is putting up picture after picture after picture of what you do, nobody is going to love you. They're just going to see you constantly on the side. It's like having someone at a party go, guess what I do, guess what I do, guess what I do, guess what I do, guess what I do. Can we talk about me? Me, me, me. I love me. Who do you love? Me. Obviously, you love me. That's not going to go down well, okay? So think about your community that you're trying to build that gets you the reputation, that gets you the clients. Start putting back. And if you go, again, I haven't got time, this is part of your business plan. How else are you going to market yourself? Hope that you put an advert out on Facebook and people are going to come running to you? It's not how it works. You should know this by now, because it doesn't work with you. Why would it work with anyone else? Your clients have no connection with you. Are you hiding behind a logo? I have never seen a client book someone based on a logo, and yet so many photographers spend so much time on their logos. And I get, okay, it's cute, but people buy from people. How many more times do people need to be told this? They buy from people. So if all they see is a logo and they're about to bring your kid to you or have a portrait session, how do they know what you're like? What kind of personality do you give off? Don't be afraid to get in front of your brand. I talk about this in so many other videos, maybe some up here or link, but please get in front of your brand. Be proud of what you create. You know, people want connection. And on that same note, are you putting up posts with no connection whatsoever? Are you just going, oh, here's a picture of a baby. Yay, connection, tell someone a story, tell someone about the shoot, tell them something that's insightful that gets them to interact with you. If you are not causing them to want to write a response by literally giving them, you might even have to spoon feed these people. You might have to go, what's your favorite brand of cornflake if you've done a kiddie breakfast shoot, for God's sake? Just think what, you literally have to take the horse to the water and show it how to drink. You ain't gonna make it drink, but you can show it. So give it the opportunity to respond. And so many of you will just put something up and just leave it. And then you won't even talk to people on there. You won't interact with, you won't with comments. Don't just put hugs, love. Actually do comments back. And if you tell me I don't have time, then this is part of your business. This should be in your business plan. You should be making time for this, because it isn't all sitting on the computer and just surfing the internet and having fun. It isn't just editing. When you run a business, you have to be every part of that business. And this part is the marketing and sales side of it. And if all you're doing is the editing and photographic side, you are seriously failing on the other side of the business. People want to know about you. People want to get to know you, and they want connection. You've just got to show them how to make that connection with you. And it starts with you. This is quite hard. So your work needs work. And I don't mean that, oh, but my mum thinks it's great, so therefore it's great. No, it's not great. Because everyone's work has room for improvement. That's how we learn. Our clients develop, we should be developing alongside them. We should be giving them what they don't know they want, essentially. The kind of imagery that they want. We need to be seeking out new products. You have to put time in for education for yourself, learning more. Your work will always need tweaking and fine tuning. If you just settle, you're not giving your clients innovation, and clients want dependable, but still beings taking a step forward. So follow on with what you're doing, but make sure you're developing it with every step you're taking. Every move you make. Sorry, that's terrible. But anyway, if you've got to stop thinking that you know everything. You have to do it. And if someone says, oh, but my clients like it. Well, if your clients like it, why aren't they booking in? Because if work doesn't impress them, if work doesn't make them stand out, they ain't booking in. They ain't wanting to hang out with you. You haven't planned. I've talked about this numerous times. You start a business and you go, yay, I've started a business. And there's crickets. Why? Because you haven't made a plan. You haven't done your marketing. You haven't gone, right, this is what I'm going to do, this is what I'm going to do, this is what I'm going to do. And you think somehow it's going to fall from the sky and you're going to have it handed to you, and all your friends who work with you are going to hand over all their info. It doesn't really work like that. You have to be autonomous with it. You have to go and look for it yourself. Google is online, you know? Google it and go find out. What's this? What's this? What does this do? How can I do this? I haven't got time to do that. If you haven't got time to learn, and you don't want to pay someone, you shouldn't be having a business. I'm going to be honest, this was the brutal one. If you are not making time to educate yourself, if you are not making time to do the back end of your business, and if you stupidly, and I'm going to say this, believe that a photography business is purely based on the images and how pretty you can make somebody, then you are woefully wrong. I see people who will spend more time choosing a logo than a client management software. I've seen more people spend time on a Facebook page than their website. I've seen more people spend time editing and not actually marketing. You should be not working so hard. You should be working better. I'm not going to tell you that you don't want to bring the big bucks, and there is hard work in every aspect, but if you can't do it and you don't want to outsource it, then you make a decision if being in business is right for you. Because when you are self-employed, when you run a business, you have to be every job role that is ever going to exist. Payroll, marketing, stylist, the photographer, the assistant, the caterer, the cleaner, the sales rep, the accounting system, whatever it is, you've got to be able to do all those. And if you don't have the skills or the time to do all of those, you need to outsource them somewhere else. And if you're not comfortable doing that, then business may not be for you. And I said this was going to be brutal, because so many times I see this online where people want the answers handed to them, but they don't want to learn them, or they don't have the time. And you know what? If it's important enough, you will make the time. And if someone says to me, oh, I've got this going on in my life. Yes, we're all allowed downtime. We're all allowed breaks. But you know what? You do the hard stuff now. You set up the scheduling. You set up the autonomy of the system. And eventually it gets easier. It gets so I did not jump into my business and go, I got all the answers straight away. It's taken years and years, admittedly. But you know what? Once I got that client management software sorted, I suddenly knew where all my leads were coming from. It automatically invoices. Once it goes to the invoice, it marks that it's been paid. It chases them automatically. I don't have to chase people. I have, when I send my images to someone, it reminds them that the gallery is closing down. They only have X amount of more days to choose their favorites, X amount of days to download their images. All automated, and I can carry on with the next shoot. All of this stuff goes on. You run a business. You chose to run a business. Okay, this was brutal, I admit. But I think it needed to be said. And if you don't agree with me, I'm all open because this is business and we're adults and we can discuss this. So put it in the comments below. But if you like this, go subscribe to me. I appreciate it. And I love that you guys are asking me these questions. You asked me to do this one. I've done it. I've done it as brutally as I can without being too horrible. I keep spraying. I apologize. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that bell button. I'll see you all on the next one. Check out my links as well. Bye.